Welcome to the Vids on Vids series, where we show you how to use Google Vids, Workspace's latest AI-powered video creation app and its features. In this episode, we'll cover how to use video placeholders and what they are, where to access the recording studio inside Vids, and how to use it, how to collaborate in Vids, and lastly, we'll highlight recording best practices. Okay, let's get started. First, let's talk about video placeholders. If you're using a template or using Gemini to help generate a first draft, you'll notice that Vids adds placeholder content, including videos, to your scenes. In some scenes, you may notice a person talking to the camera. Those video placeholders are where it may make sense to record yourself or a colleague to deliver your message to build connection. When you hover over a placeholder, you have a few options. You can select the checkbox to keep the media suggestion or replace it with something else. There's a variety of options. If you'd like to record yourself, simply select the Record Video button, which will automatically open Vids in Product Recording Studio. Want to add a video placeholder? Just head to the Insert menu, select Video Placeholder, and choose your shape, and then click to insert into the scene. To access the recording studio, you can get there from the vids.new screen, or by clicking in an existing video placeholder, or in the Scripts panel in the right sidebar of Vids. Once you click into a script and click the Record Myself button, it has a variety of options. To record yourself speaking your script, tap the camera option. You'll see that there's a teleprompter directly below your eyeline with some options like read-along or rolling to help you deliver your message with confidence. Once you click record, it will count you in and begin recording. You'll have options to preview or, when you're ready, insert directly into your vid. It's that easy. When building videos and vids, it's really easy to collaborate and works just like docs, slides, or sheets. You can easily just tag colleagues into scenes where you'd like them to record or contribute content. To share permissions and allow collaborators to view, edit, or comment, just head to the Share button in the top right and add their emails. Before we wrap, a few best practices and tips to make sure your video is engaging and lands your message. First, use faces to direct attention. Incorporating people into your video helps improve connection and attention, especially if they appear early on in the video. Next, talk to the camera. Neuroscience shows that first-person information, shared by speaking directly to camera, can disproportionately influence behavior. Show, don't tell. When teaching a concept, show a visual of the concept to make it stick. Avoid using a head on recording. And don't forget, when recording your screen, set your screen dimensions to what you want to record. Lastly, when importing recordings, make sure they are no longer than 30 minutes. Then, it's best practice to trim it down. And just like that, we've shown you how to use the recording studio and collaborate in Google Vids to easily create engaging videos. We'll continue to add episodes as new features drop. Feel free to let us know what you'd like to see us cover next in the comments below. Get started today at vids.new. Thanks for watching.